it comes to the 90s, man, you just gotta love the 90s. Especially when it came to the urban sitcoms, man, that was out during that time. Cosby Show, Fresh Prince, Bel-Air, Different World, Family Matters, Steve Urkel, Living Single, just to name a few, but all those sitcoms in the 90s, man. But Martin, nothing compares to Martin. Around 8 o'clock, 8:30, Thursdays, that was it, the Martin Show. I mean, Dragonfly Jones, Otis, Shanaynay, Jerome, Roscoe, all the characters he played, Mama Payne. I mean, that show also broke a lot of stars too, man. Reginald Ballard as Bruh Man, Tracy Morgan as Hustle Man, Tisha Campbell as Gina, Tashina Arnold, Pam, Carl Anthony Payne, Cole, and Tommy, Thomas Michael Ford. And that's who this episode was dedicated to. Now see, Thomas Michael Ford was born September 5th, 1964 in Los Angeles, California. Now, growing up, Tommy was a church boy, man. He really wanted to be a preacher, but he also could make you laugh when he was younger. He never smoked or drank a day in his life, especially after seeing his biological father, who became a heroin addict. Now see, by the time he was in high school, he started taking drama classes for acting, and he was inspired by actors James Earl Jones and Lou Gossett Jr. because they was like tall, big men like him. After graduating high school, he attended Long Beach City College in 1985, earning an Associate of Arts degree. Then he transferred to the University of Southern California, where he graduated with a Bachelor of Fine Arts degree in acting. Now, after college, he landed a role on the show A Different World as Jaleesa's ex-husband. That was his first role. But see, on that set, A Different World, he would become friends with Jasmine Guy, who at the time was doing a movie, Harlem Nights, with Eddie Murphy, Red Fox, and Richard Pryor. With her connections, she got Tommy an audition in the movie, and he landed the role as Tommy Smalls, which at first was handed to Arsenio Hall to play the role. But when Eddie Murphy and Tommy rehearsed the lines together, the chemistry was just better. Then after that, 1992, he played a drug dealer named Meek in the Kid and Play movie Class Act. That same year, Martin Lawrence had got his own show on Fox, and he wanted Tommy to be part of it. Now see, Tommy and Martin, right, they were friends, and they used to hang out way before the show Martin came together. They go way back to the theater days when they was just trying to make it into Hollywood when he was younger. See, Martin was a wild young boy, and he was a Golden Glove boxing champion. And even though Tommy was about 6'4", he was one of the big guys, he had to still calm Martin down because Martin liked to fight when they used to hang out. Now see, during that time, Tommy had got his own deal too for his own TV show. But his manager, they just thought Martin's show was terrible and it wouldn't last. So he told Tommy to just go do the show, see how it go, then you can pursue with yours. But the Martin show ended up becoming a huge success, airing 5 seasons on Fox from August 27th, 1992 to May 1st, 1997. Making it one of the network's highest rated shows during the sitcom's run. In the Martin show, he played Martin's best friend, Tommy Strong, known for not having a job. He was also the only character on Martin's show to appear in every episode on that show. Now, Tommy was also nominated for a 1996 AACP Image Award for Outstanding Supporting Actor in a Comedy Series for his performance on Martin. Now, see, when the Martin show was over, there was supposed to be a spinoff too with Pam, man. Because at the end of the last show, she became an A&R at the record label when the show ended. I think her show was called Going for Mine, but it was never picked up by Fox Network. Anyway, now, after the Martin show ended, Tommy would appear in more shows and movies. He appeared in New York's Undercover as Lieutenant Malcolm Baker, and he had a recurring role on the UPN sitcom, The Parkers, with Monique and Countess Vaughn as Mel Parker, Nikki's former husband and the father of Kim Parker. He also did the Jamie Foxx show. Now, he was also a judge on the TV One comedy competition called Who Got Jokes, hosted by Bill Bellamy. They call him the Pope of Comedy on that show. Years later, Tommy would go on to become a motivational speaker, touring all around the country about nonviolence and empowerment for the youths. Now, he also directed a documentary for kids dealing with bullying. He also wrote over 14 inspirational books and had a line of ties called Tommy Ties, which sold for about $75 a piece. But on October 12, 2016, Tommy Ford died after an aneurysm in his abdomen ruptured just 2 weeks after having knee surgery. He had just gave his fans a positive update on his knee surgery just days before his death. But after feeling sick, he was hospitalized and his health declined, forcing him to be put on life support. And the doctor said that there was no hope, so his family made the decision to take him off life support. There were rumors of a reboot of The Martin Show where everybody was getting back together, but I don't know how that's going to work without Tommy, but you know, hey, I still want to see The Martin Show if it happens. He was 52 years old. R.I.P. Tommy Ford.